you know, I think Jackson's story really started in about January of 2010. Lisa and I had talked and decided we wanted to have another kid because we'd always wanted a big family. And so we tried for about 6 months and we didn't get pregnant. And then in the spring of 2010, we finally found out on a trip to Indiana, actually. We were looking at starting a church in Indiana. And we were back here, and she took a pregnancy test. And the results came back, and she saw them that she wasn't pregnant again, and got angry and took the test and threw it in the trash can and laid on the bed and pouted. We thought that was the end of that, and I picked it back up, and I said, really, look at this. It looks like there's a line. So she went back, and a third time looked at it, and she finally saw what I was seeing. And we found out that she was pregnant that morning in a hotel room. So that's the Jackson story and how it began.
And then we had been trying for a while, so I had brought a book that I made with pictures of Jake and his grandparents, and I gave it to Bill and Joyce. And so when she was flipping through, there was a picture that says, I'm a big brother, we're pregnant again. And I brought that just in case, and it turns out that we were able to give it to her, and she was thrilled.
We're really, really, really excited for our family to expand. And we had just moved here, hadn't even really got everything moved in yet, and it was September. And we went for her 18-week checkup to actually find out the gender of the baby at a 4D ultrasound.
We found out that it's a boy. And we were very excited about that Jake was gonna have a little brother. And while we were sitting there looking at the images, Josh notices that something doesn't quite look right. And we asked her if she knew what it was, and she said that she didn't know and that we should make an appointment to see our doctor.
I just remember sitting there and seeing that he had this growth on his stomach that didn't look normal. Began to realize he might have something wrong with him. And in particular, I thought maybe he might have Down syndrome. We went into that appointment and found out that it was much worse than Down syndrome. In fact, we found ourselves later wishing that he had Down syndrome. They weren't for sure what it was, but it looked like he might have trisomy either 18 or trisomy 13, which he told us was not compatible with life.
It turns out that he had trisomy 18 full, which means that every single one of his cells in his DNA had a triple 18. And that is what they say is incompatible with life.
We quickly found out there was absolutely nothing we could do about it.
Those first 3 weeks were the hardest 3 weeks of my life. Just getting that news that I was carrying a baby that was gonna pass away, but I just didn't know when. Picking a date for your child to come in the world, but you're also picking the date that he could have left us, because we didn't know if he was gonna make it. So February 23rd at 4 o'clock, he was planned on coming for the C-section.
Baby's heart rate looks beautiful. Mama's heart rate, when she gets nervous, it tries to get up there with babies.
What she worries about.
They're getting ready to go in and give her a spinal, and the C-section will start here at 7 p.m. on Wednesday, February 23rd. We've been through a whirlwind the last 6 months. This is feels like one more piece of the puzzle. The process has been at times exciting, at times nerve-wracking, at times emotional and frustrating.
I could just remember
standing in there with a couple of people and having no clue what we're about to get into.
I'm in the delivery room and you're sitting next to me and your eyes are red and you're on the verge of tears and you're really scared, and I'm just looking at you and I'm thinking that this is gonna be okay. We finally get to meet him and we're right here. Like, this is it. This is what we've been waiting for.
So I heard time of birth 7:35, but I hadn't heard a cry. And so I got really nervous and I said, has he been born? And they said, yeah, he's been born. They have him over on the table trying to resuscitate him right now because he wasn't breathing.
And I can look in, and then I saw Jackson. It wasn't a very good color. And then the nurse is just right by me and I can see her pushing the button and she is supplying every breath for him. But I mean, it was ownership. I mean, he was mine. And to finally put like a face and a picture to the love and the just care and all the prayers. It's finally. All of our senses were just on peak and on alarm, and we were just waiting for one of those times for them to say, yeah, this is it, you know? And so he lasted 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, and every day we would celebrate his birth.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Justin. Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Whether we sang to him, or we got him a cupcake, or, you know, we just loved him and hugged him and held him, you know, at 7:35, we were always thankful that he was still there that day.
So we had seen all these positive things happen. He was doing much better. And then we ran these two tests to try and get him off the ventilator, and he reacted terribly to those tests. His levels are just plummeting, and the doctors are having to revive him at times. They took him off the ventilator, they took the tube out, and he tried to take a gasp or two, but he never breathed.
I got to see his face for the first time. And it was all covered with tape. And I never got to kiss his lips until they took the tube out and he was struggling to breathe. I wasn't prepared for him to be so beautiful. It was very peaceful. We were praying over him and looking at him and kissing him, and I remember even holding him and looking at him, and my hands were on his heart so I could feel his heartbeat, and it was getting slower and slower. And then at 8:05, they finally told us that he had passed.
Definitely could never imagine going through something like this and not having a relationship with God and people that God is using on a daily basis in our lives. That was the thing that got us through the lowest of the lows. She started this blog as therapy, and at one point she started having thousands of people log on and reading Jackson's story well before his birth. And when he was finally born, then hundreds of thousands of people were getting on.
And I'm okay with him being here and feeling privileged to have carried him, because his life did have purpose and he affected so many lives and he has saved lives.
And the amount of impact that human beings can have on each other and to make a difference is very real. And God could use a two-week-old kid with trisomy 18 that has no chance of survival and is incompatible with life to do things that most of us would only dream of, to have that kind of impact in the world.
He didn't say a word. He didn't say, I love you. He hadn't smiled yet. He was just there letting God use his life.